Every now and then you wondered, was it really real? Did you fall in love, or was it just a dream? Nothing ever lasts forever, or so it seems. Well, maybe in time we both can see. Though you may be far away, my heart will always be yours. And if we both just give it time, we'll get what we want. I gotta say, hey, we're not saying goodbye. Though we are far, I've got to say hello. Don't wanna let you go. As far as I'm concerned, you're here with me now, and it's hello, hello, hello. Never did believe that I could feel this way. I kept my feelings inside. I used to run away.
I'm here, dear.
Hi, Mum. Where's Dad?
He's gone into London to visit an old friend. Where are the kids?
They're still at school. The break next week.
Oh. And Oliver?
What?
As ever.
You better watch out for him. He works way too hard.
We need the money, Mum. Especially now we're trying to finish the house in France.
Is it not finished yet?
French don't do things in a hurry.
But it's been 2 years.
I know. And Oliver is getting really annoyed. He's just had enough of it now.
I don't blame him, my dear.
Fancy a cup of tea?
Ooh, definitely. I'd love a cup of tea, my dear.
Sanjay!
Come in, dear! Come in!
What are you doing up there?
Nothing! Just getting ready!
What time is it, dear?
7! It's already 7:10. Why you call them, I'll never understand.
Ralphie's a good colleague. Is the dinner ready?
I'm getting there.
Get it ready.
It's going to be here. Oh, the bell's gone.
I'm going to get the door.
Hey, Sanjay.
Long time. How you been, eh?
I'm good as gold.
How long is it now?
Too bloody long.
Man, no wonder you're looking older.
You're looking older and bolder.
We better go here.
Hey, Sanjay, do you remember the time when your boss told you what to do with the briefcase?
Shove it up your ass and don't come back ever. He was a total idiot. Mm.
He made the company money, man.
Hey, we all made the company money. Yes. Not just him, the little shit.
No, not for me, no.
Oh, come on, Indira. What's the matter with you? Loosen up a little bit.
Come on, Indira.
Have a little fun.
Yeah. Just a little bit, Mum.
There we are. Now we're swinging.
Hey, be careful. She'll be on top of the table next.
Or maybe under it.
Yes, but with all.
Hey, come on, Indira. What do you say, huh?
A little bit of rumpy pumpy later? Hmm? How about it?
Dessert, everyone.
Nice dessert.
Oh.
Maybe a little cream later?
Maybe later.
Lovely dinner, Sanjay. Oh. Anyway, are you enjoying your retirement, my friend? Oh,
very much so. I don't know how I plan to work. The days just seem to roll.
You should make the most of it. To tell you the truth, I can't wait for my big day.
How long have you got then?
This time next year.
Really?
But I know my boss don't want to let me go.
Yeah?
I should be grateful
for you. Of course.
I should be.
Yeah.
But anyway, what are you doing over the weekend?
I'm off to Brighton tomorrow. A young couple?
Funny you should say that. I met a lovely little lady.
Really?
Lovely on the internet.
Yeah?
I'm telling you, you should try it, man.
Yeah.
You should try it. You'll have a great time. Are you okay?
I've tried that.
Yeah,
I'm alright.
Okay, well, yeah, anyway, try the internet, man.
I'll check it out. You have to come more often, man.
Sanjay, you're in my thoughts always, my friend.
Right.
Hey, what are you doing, Sanj?
Ah, looking at a nice pair of blue tits.
What's that?
Nothing, dear. Just bird watching.
Yeah, well, don't forget your doctor's appointment tomorrow.
Well, I haven't forgotten. I suppose he's going to tell me to stop taking bloody salt.
Well, you know he's right, dear.
Yes, but I can't eat my food without taking salt. Salt adds flavour.
Sanjay, time to wake up!
Coming, dear! Ow!
Number 46, Chesterfield Lane. Yeah, I think my husband's had a heart attack.
Once you said that you needed me, now I feel so alone. Bitter memories, they stay in my mind. All the glitter turned to stone.
Oh, Sandy, for God's sake, say something. Jesus Christ. My father is a pervert. Oh, I can't stand this. Mum, why did you do this to us? It's beyond me. Swinger, Sanjay. Never. I don't believe it. That's what it looks like. I mean, he said there were couples. Well, how many? Lots. Lots. Oh my God, and you never knew. Didn't know a thing. What do you think? I'm a swinger too. I never knew anything. I'll be buggered. He did that as well, and not just once. What are you going to do? Well, it's not as if I can confront him now, can I? Well, they say we all have our own dark secrets. When he suddenly had his, I found videos too. I haven't looked. I'm too scared. You're going to. But a side of me wants to get to the bottom of it. Maybe it's best left. You can't stop digging around. It won't bring him back, will it? Yeah, but I'm angry. After all these years, I didn't really know him. Did you have a good sex life? It's okay in the beginning. You know, it's not as if we ran through the cornfields naked and smoked pot or anything. Normal sex life. Jack and I haven't done it for years. Well, except for the odd blowjob after he's been surfing the internet. You're amazing. So what are you going to do? I don't know. Are you crazy? An orgy? Me? But I can't go on my own. You're supposed to be my best friend. Why the bloody hell do you want to go? I just want to know what he found so interesting, that's all. I'll tell you what he found interesting. A bunch of dirty housewives desperate for an extra few inches with Frankfurt. I don't want to get to know them or anything. I just want to see what they're like. Don't you know? I do. I don't have to go there to realise that. Well, are you going to come with me or not? No. Indra, don't go.
You're supposed to be my best friend.
This is totally ridiculous, Mum.
What is your problem? It's not like I'm going to be throwing my knickers in the air or anything.
The place will be full of perverts. God only knows what they're expecting you to do.
Mother, I'm beginning to think that you need to see a psychiatrist. Oh no, Sandy. You may have some issues, but really, you don't need to go to those lengths.
Don't wait up.
This is madness, Mother.
Have fun.
Oh, it's so jolly.
Welcome to the Pleasure Dome.
My God, is this what you wanted to see? It's bloody perverse. Can we go now? Oh, no, Mary.
Well, you're perfect. What are you into?
Into?
I mean, what is your preference? 6 weeks.
That's it. I'm off. You stay if you like, but I'm not.
Ladies, leaving so soon? Was it your first time?
Yes, it is. Oh. And our last.
Oh. Well, if you're looking for a lift, I could take you home.
We are perfectly fine, thank you. Oh, yes. You'll probably expect a five-knuckle shuffle on the back seat. I've met his type before.
Listen, it's no problem. I mean, do I look like a man you can't trust?
One word, prostitutes. I could tell that pervy old git talk about desperate. I'm glad we didn't accept a lift, otherwise he'd know where we lived. God forbid.
Oh.
Oh, Indra, you didn't.
Well, he said he worked in Highgate. You know, he might drop in and say hello or something. And anyway, you're so drunk. He's not going to remember anything, Mary. You worry too much.
Did you tell him about Sanjay?
Of course I did.
Hope you know what you've done.
I haven't done anything wrong. I'm on my own, in case you hadn't noticed.
Exactly. He's a sexual predator. Oh. He'll be banging at your door. He'll probably come banging at your back one too, if you get my drift. He looks like the bum sort.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Mary. Don't forget, we're at the gym tomorrow morning.
This is supposed to be good for your joints. It's bloody killing mine. They're unfit. That's why, my dear. So, are you going to go again? No, I'm not. That bloody awful place. And what of that Sierra chap? What about him? He's a pervert like all the rest. I think he likes you. Oh, rubbish. Really? I could see. I don't care what you saw. It's hard enough coming to terms with my husband's antics. What was I thinking? We going for coffee? I've got family coming round. I've got to do the shopping. Any news on the will? Have an appointment on Tuesday. Not looking forward to that either. Oh well, best get it done.
We are the future.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, Carrie, hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Come to the kitchen,
ma'am.
Oliver, lay the table.
Olivia, lay the table. Come on.
Oh, my God.
Oops. Sorry, darling.
So how are things between the two of you now?
Us? Jolly as ever. He doesn't understand me, and I don't understand him. Perfect marriage, I guess.
So no action in the bedroom, then?
Mother, please. I'm not going to talk to you about my sex life.
Ooh. I'm only trying to help, darling.
Well, Ollie,
tell Mum the good news.
What news?
Well, from Monday, I'm going to be the new headmaster of a new school.
Oh, well done you.
Yes.
More money.
Oh, that's fantastic news.
However, carries a lot more responsibility.
Well, that's not quite your strong point, is it?
And what's that supposed to mean?
It's not. You struggle to supervise your own kids, let alone someone else's.
Well, I supervise them well enough when you're off on a bloody conference.
Now, kids.
Yeah, that's only because I have to.
Who's been paying the bloody mortgage?
What do you mean by that? I pay my bloody way.
Okay.
Is that what you call it, huh?
Ridiculous.
Well, it's not so ridiculous when I'm paying for the bloody house in France now, is it?
You're much too hard on him.
Mom, I am I'm the one who's working all the time.
You're the one who took the bloody job. You wanted more money, an extension here, furniture there. I'm beginning to think this house in France is just nothing but trouble.
Oh, so I am at fault, huh?
No, I'm not saying it's always you. Oliver's a good family man.
I can't believe you're actually siding with him.
I'm not backing him. You know, life's hard enough.
Well, it might well get harder for him.
Good morning, Rosie.
Morning.
Had a nice weekend?
Great. Met another idiot bloke. That's all I seem to be doing lately. Why is it all men expect something on the first night?
Well, the nature of the beast, I guess. Mm-hmm. You should come out with me one night, and I'll show you good fun.
Yeah, I've heard all about your wild weekends.
No, no, no. I'm serious. I always have fun. We can go out for a meal and then go on to a discotheque. I can really shake my bum.
Oh, if only you were my age. Besides, I think you'd wear me out.
The chance would be a fine thing.
I should chase my secretary. You got any more like that?
No, she's one of a kind.
Oh, yeah. Could you email those details over to John at the record company as soon as possible? He's really on my case.
Okay.
Hey, by the way, what time did you leave the party last night?
I left early. Wasn't feeling good.
Oh, shame. You missed the big bang. Hmm? No, there were five guys around that little blonde sort, Jodie. We'll continue this conversation later.
Yeah, I guess that's me, yeah.
Layla Green.
Nice to meet you, Lady Green.
Nice to meet you too. And this is our lovely teaching assistant, Matilda.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, Matilda.
Marcus, you're not meant to be with Mr. Wilkinson right now.
Yeah, whatever.
You'll be in detention.
He's the bad boy at the school. Be wary of him.
Well, there's always one.
Welcome to Afghan High. This is my room, room number 9. If you need anything, you come find me.
Right, number 9 is my favourite number.
This is the will belonging to Sanjay Rendell. I hereby state that after my death, the family house be left to my wife, Indra Rendell. And all contents within the property, excluding my army medals, Napoleonic figurines, which I leave to my loving daughter, Sandy Sanderson.
What the hell am I supposed to do with them? What do I know about pretty soldiers?
Which, after value estimating 2005, were worth £50,000. For the house in the south of France, I leave to Janine Sarah Jessel.
I beg your pardon? A who?
Janine Sarah Jessel.
And who is that?
I haven't the foggiest.
But Mr. Robinson, there must be some mistake. No one's ever heard of this Janine.
There's no mistake. Now, I'm sorry, but I really must get to my meeting. If you have any further questions, please contact my secretary.
I don't know.
What's all this about? Who's this bloody woman? Are you gonna answer me?
I don't know.
Oh my God.
Banff was having an affair, wasn't he?
Now, you don't know that.
Of course he was. It's so bloody obvious.
Oh, Sandy, stop whinging.
I can't do this.
She's too much.
Yes. She bloody well is.
You know, you and the man were married for the better part of 45 years. And for what? And I always thought that after you retired, life would be perfect.
Life is not perfect. That's just for the moment. See you later.
Bloody Janine. He's fathered a love child with her. That's what's happened here.
Sandy, you don't know the ins and outs.
Oh, wake up, Ollie. My father, he was a dirty old bastard. All men are the same. They can't keep it in their bloody pants for longer than 5 bloody minutes.
Oh, rubbish, Sandy. And don't tarnish everyone with the same brush. Now, let's just wait before we start judging him.
Can't you just see what's happened here? My father had an affair and possibly wasn't the first. And now some tart of a woman, she's trying to muscle in on my property. The house that my father promised me, it was mine. Always, always, everything always just happens to me.
Oh, God, yeah, everything happens to you. Stop, stop, stop. No, 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 I've had enough.
What are you doing? Are you crazy?
Don't give a damn.
Piss off then!
Oh,
hello. Oh, I was just passing by and thought I'll give you a knock. Maybe you invite me for a cup of tea or something?
Sure. Can you just give me a couple of minutes? I'll be with you in a couple of minutes.
You got a beautiful garden. Wow, it's great!
I didn't know whether to come.
I'm glad you did.
Is that your husband?
Oh, yes, it is.
Handsome man.
Oh, thank you. Do you have milk and sugar?
Two, please.
Sure. Oh, do sit down. You're making me really nervous.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I'm nervous too.
Maybe I shouldn't have come here.
It's all right. We're friends. You know, you really shouldn't let her treat you like this.
You're very beautiful.
Morning, my little stud muffin.
Oh yeah, impressive, was I?
Very. You know my home is your home, right?
Really?
I know, it feels a bit strange.
Yeah,
I don't know, I just don't know if I should be here. I don't know.
You're more than welcome to stay.
Thank you. I'm gonna be late, I've gotta get changed. Have a good day.
Mr. Sanson, your wife is on 911 again.
Thank you, Melanie. Sorry.
It's okay.
Ollie, it's important that we find out who this bloody bitch is.
Right.
Well, it's not right that Dad left the house in France to her, is it? What was he thinking?
Okay, I'll make some inquiries.
Right. Where were you last night?
I stayed at Mike's, slept on the sofa. Bloody dog's hairs all over me, been sneezing all morning.
Ah. Don't forget to make the inquiries.
Right. Yep, I'm on it. Look, we'll have to continue this meeting later. I'm sorry.
How are you, Mrs. Randall?
I'll stop being so bloody formal, Si. I've known you long enough.
I know. So how can I help?
I found a lump.
I see, and where's the lump?
On my left breast, and more recently another on the right.
Okay, let's take a look. Thank you. Right, all done.
It's cancer, isn't it?
Let's wait and see before we do a diagnosis.
Oh, piss off, Si. I'm not stupid.
I'll book a scan and we'll take the necessary tests. Then we'll take it from there. So, how's the family?
I have a neurotic daughter. And I recently found out my dead husband was a serial pervert. Apart from that, everything's just dandy.
Thank you.
Every now and then you wondered, was it really real? Did you fall in love, or was it just a dream? Nothing ever lasts forever, or so it seems. Well, maybe in time we both can see. Though you may be far away, my heart will always be yours. And if we both just give it time, we'll get what we want. I gotta say, hey, we're not saying goodbye. Though we are far, I've got to say hello. Don't wanna let you go. As far as I'm concerned, you're here with me now, and it's hello, hello.
Hi, Mum.
Baby!
I'm really sorry for yesterday.
Oh, don't be silly.
Mum, I found an earring in Ollie's shirt last night in the wash basket.
Oh, no.
I bet you think I deserve it.
No, no, don't be silly, dear.
Let's
this later, shall we? Sorry? Why don't we just discuss this a little later? Mother, this is serious. Oh, Sandy, give it a rest. You're not the only one in this family, you know. You obviously don't care.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, fine.
Sorry to disturb you. I'm looking for a Janine Jessup.
Oh, yeah? And who are you?
My name's Oliver. Oliver Sanderson.
Right. What do you want her for?
Well, it's rather a private matter, really. Are you a husband?
I wouldn't marry her if the last hour on earth.
Does she live here?
Might do, might not. Look, who are you?
Do you mind if I come in?
I know. I have been at it all night. What can I do? The girls love me. Sorry, gentlemen.
I really can't believe this. I'm just so shocked. Must be someone at the school. I bet you it's that Jane. She looks like a slut. I saw her once at the Christmas party. Like a bitch on heat she was. Oh, Sandy, you really need to calm down. Stay calm. Why are you not helping me? Since Dad died, I feel so alone in this family. You self-centered little bitch, is that what you think? The whole bloody family revolves around you. Well, perhaps if you showed Ollie a little more attention, he wouldn't have strayed in the first place. Always bloody you. Well, enough is enough. Give it up or you're going to lose a good thing.
You really have changed, Mum.
Yeah, well, you know, maybe I have.
Hello, it's only little me.
Hi there.
Just saw Sandy looking upset. Is everything okay?
Just another day in this bloody house, that's all.
A free bit out in France? Nah, don't get it.
Well, it's a touch complicated, really. You see, my father-in-law was very wealthy, and he left the house to her. And nobody knew this except him.
What, she did bait him or something?
No, you're kidding me, bro.
Well, we don't know the facts. That's why we're trying to find her. Now, can you help?
Slack.
Guess what I've been doing today?
What?
Surfing the internet. For swingers parties. There's one on tonight, but me. Should we go? She may be there, you know.
Who?
Janine Jessup, of course. Who else?
Okay. Oh yeah, what the bloody hell do you want, you bastard?
Looking for Janine.
I haven't seen her for weeks, so go on, clear off. Get out now.
Actually, it's not him that's looking for Janine, I am. Would you know where she is?
Oh yeah, what are you then, old Bill?
No, I'm not old Bill. Somebody's left a part of a will, and it's hugely important we find out.
A will?
What's that all about then?
Some old git she's been banging.
We don't know that yet.
Well, she invited me to a party tonight, but I can't go because of my husband. And he stole a bloody mobile phone.
And do you know where that is?
Can't remember. It's on my phone. I'll go and get it now. And as for you, I'm watching you, all right?
Okay. Gotta keep calm. Yes, hi, Sandy.
What did you find out?
I found the boyfriend, but I think they've since split up.
You must find out, Ollie. Can't you try harder?
I'm on my way now. I'm on my way to find her.
It is important.
Look, you know, I've got a really bad signal. Can I call you later? Thank you. Hi, how are you?
You left school in a hurry.
Yeah, sorry about that. Had a family emergency.
Is everything okay?
Just the usual dramas.
Okay. Well, I was wondering if you wanted to come over later, because I'll be cooking a curry. Hello? Are you still there?
Layla, can I call you a bit later? Just that I'm really busy at the moment.
All right, well, maybe some other time then.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Bye.
All right. Bye.
Someone's getting a second furry cup.
This is the house?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yes, my naughty, dirty boy. I'm gonna ride you all the way to heaven.
Excuse me, I'm looking for Janine Jessup.
Or her?
Upstairs, on the left.
Let me do the talking. You okay? Excuse me, I'm looking for Janine Jessup.
Oh, her? She's really popular. Upstairs, on the left.
Thank you.
Miss Green?
Of course.
Lovely. Cheers, mate.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Indira!
Sorry, Rob. Do I know you?
Yes, it's me, Sheila.
Well, you horrible, filthy beast. Oh, I think I'm gonna faint.
Indira!
Oliver! What are you doing here?
Well, I might ask you the same bloody question.
I'm looking for someone.
Who?
Me?
You?
Not him.
Well, who are you looking for then?
Janine Jessup.
Yes.
No, not you, love.
No, that's who I'm looking for.
Who?
Janine Jessup.
Yes.
No, not you, love.
I am Janine Jessup.
You bitch! No, come on. We talked in the car.
Nice to have met you, Janine. Do you come here often?
Oh. But why would he leave it to me?
Well, I was hoping you could tell me that.
I really don't know.
Well, there must have been some sort of relationship between you two.
No, there wasn't. Really, I never slept with him or anything. We never got around to it. All he wanted was talk. I thought it was strange, to be honest.
Look, the thing is, my wife was meant to receive that property, and she's absolutely devastated. I mean, you're not family, are you? I was hoping maybe we could come to some sort of an arrangement.
Yeah, of course, I understand.
Good. Okay. Look. I'll pay for some cab fare. And there's my card.
Now keep in touch.
Okay.
She's late.
I hate it when people are late.
Well, I'm in court at 3.
Did you tell her 2:30?
Of course I did.
I bet you cocked it up. You're good at that.
Sandy, I've not cocked anything up. In fact, if anyone's been cocking it up, it's been you, ever since we got bloody married.
Oliver.
No, no, Indira, it's too much. All I get is verbal abuse all the bloody time.
Oliver, just stay where you are. I'm warning you.
I really don't give a shit.
You walk away from here now, and we are finished.
Oh, you know what? Looks like you might have some more work, doesn't it?
I'm sorry.
Please take a seat.
Thank you.
We'll get you to sign over the rights. We won't be signing anything.
I beg your pardon?
We decided to keep the property.
But you can't. It doesn't belong to her.
Well, that's not exactly true, is it? You see, your husband didn't have a very good relationship with Janine. However, they did become very close.
What are you talking about?
It seems the time your husband spent with Janine, things started to unfold and fall into place. I guess what I'm trying to say is, Janine Jessup is your husband's daughter.
What? This man's insane. This is ridiculous.
Oh yes, it's all there. He decided to leave the house in France to Miss Jessup. She's the legal owner, I'm afraid, and there's nothing anyone can do about it.
Well, we can fight it.
Then you have a tough battle ahead of you. Good day.
I don't believe this.
Oh, not you! Go away!
Is it possible to have a civilized conversation?
Well, it depends.
On what?
On whether you're going to tell me any more lies.
Look, I come in peace. I have embarrassed you.
Yes, you have.
I'm sorry. What's baffling me is, what the hell were you doing there?
Now there's a question. I think we'd best go inside.
Wow. There we are. Tell me. There is one good thing that has happened. At least, it makes me look like a bloody saint. Oh, sorry. Bad taste.
Time is a great healer, Indra.
I suppose you're right.
What the hell do you want? I've told you already, you're not signing your shitty contract. What is it with you people? Yeah, think you can boss it around, you've got a bit of money. But you can't tell me or her what to do. All right, get off. Get off the driver, set the dogs on you. Have him!
I want to restart. You in my life. I know it's early days. But what I mean is, I want to give us a chance, a slow chance. I mean, take it day by day. That is, if you will accept me.
Slow is good.
Good morning, Lucy.
Morning.
Morning, Rose.
You have a 10 o'clock at Whitehall, and Miles Green wants you to call him by 11. He needs to talk to you about the security in the concert.
Mm. Thank you. Oh, Rose, can you get me a cup of coffee?
Sure.
Ah, and a few bickies. I didn't get a chance to get my breakfast. Oh, and could you please get me Charles Metford on the phone, please?
Nice. You know, I once knew a guy who'd give extended lunch break for the odd sexual favour.
Yeah? You'll get into trouble for that.
Only if you get caught. Hey, yeah, you disappeared from the party last night.
You know, yeah.
I know. You met the lovely Janine. Beautiful. Very trim. Hey, whistle on for badminton at the Lensbury tonight?
No. I think I'll give it a miss. Actually, I'm sacked up.
You're not sick, are you?
Oh, no. Too much work on.
Okay. Hey, old QC Merton's having his party next week. Don't forget. He informs me he's got some new talent there.
Rose, put me through, please. Hi, Charles. Long time no hear.
You can just take that little tart of yours and just sod off. Here you go. Take it to your little tart and wear this.
Sandy, it's Mom. Will you give me a call when you get this message? Thank you. Bye-bye, Jolly. Ow.
Indira. What is it? What's wrong?
Nothing. I'm fine.
No. Let's go to the hospital.
No, really. Fine.
But, my dear, you are in pain.
Make me some tea or something, please.
Okay, tea coming.
Thank you. Right, well. It seems we have a difficult situation, doesn't it? I mean, this house, it belongs to the family. The true family. But it's not right, is it?
He was nice to me, you know. He visited the parties on a regular basis. All the girls knew his face. I asked him why he attended the parties. He said he couldn't understand why people got married in the first place. Sex dies off, and you start treating each other like shit. And all you really want is for someone to understand you. I guess it's not asking for too much after years of marriage, is it?
No, I suppose not. We all have desires. But how did you, get into all this?
I was working at the massage parlours. This party organiser used to come in. Simply asked me if I wanted to make some extra cash. Close your eyes and think of England, I guess. I'm going to take the house, you know. It's time to make a new start. And this is my chance. My only chance. I'm not going with Oz. I'm going to go to France, start waitressing, and learn the language, and start all over again. As you said, we all have desires.
You know what? I really don't think I blame you.
Good luck. Oh, by the way, did you ever know your mother?
Never met her. All I know is that her name is Mary. She gave me up when I was 5 months old. Nice lady.
Take care.
Hospital.
How are you?
Not too good, to be honest. Sickness, dizziness. How long have I got?
3 months. Look, I'll prescribe some morphine, and at the hospital, I'll make her as comfortable as possible.
Once you said that you needed me.
Hi, Vera. It's Ollie here. Now I feel I've got something to say. So alone. And tonight, not easy, but. We've split. And to be honest, I think this time is for real. I feel different this time, Indira. I was looking to ask if I could stay at your place for a while, just until I sort myself out. I won't be in the way, I
Hi!
Hello?
It's Sira here.
Mr. Sira who?
Oh, your mother's partner. Please don't put the phone down.
Sorry, I think you've got the wrong number.
Washing for mum. So how's she doing?
Coping, I guess. She's a tough bird.
Yeah, she is. Listen, I hope I'm not in the way here, you know?
Oh, not at all, Oliver. No.
Has Mum spoken to Sandy?
No. It seems your Sandy has cut us all off.
Well, that's my wife for you. We must run. Ciao, ciao.
Nice, warm tea.
You know, I've seen that blasted cat of Mary's dragging up a rubbish out. I'll shoot the bugger next time. Indira! 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 That's it. I'm going to call the ambulance. Hello? Ambulance? Ambulance, please!
Oh, hi, Mr. Sierra. Right. Okay, I'll come to the house.
Is everything okay?
Do you know what? I really don't know. I'll speak later.
But...
What do you want, Oliver?
I think you need to get over to the house as soon as possible. Mum's very sick.
No. Oliver, I am really busy. I haven't got time for this.
God damn you, Sandy. The bloody world doesn't revolve around you.
I've got to go, okay?
Okay. Sandy,
but... I don't know what to come in like that.
She's very frail.
Excuse me. Her pulse is very low.
Look after my grandchildren.
Of course I will, Mum.
Tell Sandy I love to marry.
She knows.
Or if she doesn't, say thank you to Sierra. Enjoyed our time together.
Where is Sierra?
Downstairs.
Mary.
I'm here, Indira.
Janine.
Oh my God. I'm sorry, Indira. Please forgive me.
By the way, did you ever know your mother?
Never met her. All I know is that her name is Mary. She gave me up when I was 5 months old.
She's gone. Passed away.
said she enjoyed the time you spent together. You're a good man. Sorry.
Once you said that you needed me. Now I feel so alone. Bitter memories, they stay in my mind. All the glitter turned to stone. Turn out so wrong. Why did we still carry on when the time is right? I know. Just turn your back and let me go.
Let me down. I let you down too.
Yeah, I guess in some ways you did.
I don't know why you ever put up with me in the first place.
Because I loved you, Sam.
How's your new lady?
We're fine. Yeah, we're all fine. We're all fine.
I can't believe Mum never told me about her cancer.
Did you ever ask? I'm sure Mum tried to reach out to you in her own way. I think even Mr. Sierra tried.
Did Mum say anything to you before she...
Yes. Yes, she did. She said, tell my daughter I love her very much. Look, Sandy, life goes on. Life goes on, and yours will too. Okay? Look, you take care.
Was it really real? Did you fall in love? Or was it just a dream? Nothing ever lasts forever, or so it seems. Well, maybe in time we both can see. Though you may be far away, my heart will always be yours. And if we both just give it time, we'll get what we want. I gotta say, hey, we're not saying goodbye. Though we are far, I've got to say hello. Don't wanna let you go. As far as I'm concerned, you're here with me now, and it's hello, hello, hello. Never did believe that I could feel this way. I kept my feelings inside. I used to run away. Since I met you, love is not a fantasy. It's here in my soul. It's the very heart of me. Though you may be far away, my heart will always be yours. And if we both just give it time, we'll get what we want. I write this testimony to the broken. So many songs about so many.